The reality is, over the last 20 years, the average weight of the average American has been rising. And we're now at the point where more than a third of our population are considered medically overweight. And a significant fraction of those are considered morbidly obese, that is, excessively obese with health consequences. We discovered for the very first time that FGF1 is important. And we discovered it's important in two ways. One, it's important when you put mice on a high-fat diet. Let's say the exact kind of diet that an American would eat. That's a high-fat, high-carbohydrate diet. These mice can't handle the feast. So that was one important thing. The other is, could they handle the famine? And they're equally disastrous at handling the famine. So the key feature of survival of the species, feast and famine, is completely compromised in these mice, yet it was missed for more than 13 years. And it was actually very surprising because it placed it in the center of one of the body's most essential processes. The secret to survival is being able to survive metabolic stress, lots of calories or not enough. And that's never how we do experiments typically. We always give animals exactly what they need, and therefore you can miss the fact that stress is the way in which we get through life, managing stress. And so we learned that this is a part of a pathway that we understand and that we can genetically dissect. And because it's one that we understand, it's one that we can also manipulate. And our lab and others have developed small molecule drugs that can manipulate this genetic switch. That's number one. Number two, there's actually a drug that has been developed for a number of years called pioglitazone, or Actos, that is sold, that is used to manage diabetes. And how that drug worked wasn't really well understood. Now that's important because the drug has many side effects. FGF1 may produce the good actions of the drug, but not have the side effects. And so it's possible that this will lead to an entirely new drug that produces the good benefits to try to defeat the problems of diabetes without having the problems that have been linked to previous kinds of drugs that are currently available. Here at the Salk, we're a basic research institute that are pulling out secrets about how certain kinds of signaling pathways in the body work. And we link these to critical aspects of normal physiology and then through genetics into the pathology. And so we quickly transition a basic research discovery, that is, how are nutrients managed at the molecular and genomic level. And now we're already translating this into its potential impact on people. And the reason it's important is that this never would have happened without the basic discovery, opening up the entire process of giving rise to something potentially a new therapeutic. So it's a beautiful example of how basic research is really the entree to the next generation of drugs. And so I'm very happy about that. And hopefully we can bring that whole reality around to make this molecule an actual new drug.